Hi, this is Lindsay Petras.
I'm Adam Sorma.
I'm Stephanie Bria.
Welcome to The Slaw.
Welcome to The Slaw.
The Slaw.
Very Local's podcast where we stay on top of all things Pittsburgh.
Each week, we highlight Pittsburgh places and Pittsburgh people.
We feature unique collaborations.
And even make some event recommendations.
The Slaw is all about the stories that make Pittsburgh, well, Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh. Hello, listeners of The Slaw. I am sitting here with Alexa Peduzzi. And Alexa is a freelance writer who has written several stories for us here at Very Local. And she's here today to tell us a little bit about her experience in blogging and writing web content, as well as plant-based and some vegan eating here in Pittsburgh. So, Alexa, welcome.
Thank you so much. I'm really excited to be here.
Yeah, we're happy to have you. And tell us a little bit about, you were telling me a little bit, you left college and got started as an IT auditor, and then started blogging, and what do you do now?
Yeah, so right now I work for a company called Food Blogger Pro, and it's a food blogging membership site. So we're both a resource and a community for aspiring food bloggers and established food bloggers. So we have different courses and different resources that people can use to start and grow and monetize their blogs. So it's great. Like, I'm just surrounded by, you know, creatives and photographers and food lovers and writers all day, every day. And it's just the best, the very, very best.
Awesome. Tell us, what's the name of your blog?
So my blog's name is Fooduzzi, and I feel like I always need to explain it because people don't really know what it is. People have guessed. Some people think that Fooduzzi means like it's a food gun, like food Uzi. Doesn't make much sense to me, but Fooduzzi is just like a play on my last name. So my last name, Peduzzi, food, Fooduzzi.
And what inspired you to start the blog? How long have you been blogging for, and what inspired you to start the blog?
Yeah, you know, I was looking back at like when I first started my blog for this interview, and it was back in December of 2014, which just seems like forever ago. Like, I was still in college. I graduated the May after that, so May of 2015. And I had been following food blogs for so long, just because I loved food. I loved, you know, photography. You know, there's nothing more beautiful than like a really just stunning food photo, in my opinion. And I just love getting to know bloggers, you know, with their blog posts. So I started hanging out with a techie friend. He's now my boyfriend, and he set up a food blog for me. And then I posted my very first post and recipe on my birthday, actually, December 18th, 2014. So the rest is history.
What was the first recipe?
Oof. It was a banana bread oatmeal recipe, and the pictures are hysterical. I've never changed them because it's like a really good reminder of like how far I've come, but that's still one of my favorite posts because it was like, it stands as like a representation of like the time I actually like did something for myself because I wanted to do it. And it's been just an incredible ride. Like, that sounds so silly, but it has been. I constantly say that starting my blog was like one of the very best decisions I could have made for myself ever.
Can you tell us a little bit about your journey to plant-based eating?
For sure. So I started eating plant-based probably around the time I started my blog, actually. It was something I was definitely interested in. And it was, to be completely fair, it was definitely coming from a not so healthy and disordered place back in the beginning. It was very health focused, and I was like, I'm going to have the perfect diet by eating plant-based. But now I have a lot more flexibility in my diet. It's a lot more fun this way now. And I just have a greater relationship with food right now, which is awesome. So now I am plant-based for floofs. Like, I love animals, and I see like no reason to have them on my plate if I can just live happily and healthily without them, you know? So that's like my main motivation right now, is just the floofs.
So, you know, a lot of folks think it's impossible to eat plant-based or vegan here in Pittsburgh. And I know you disagree with that. So tell us a little bit about what the opportunities are, what the scene is like here in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, so it's just a really cool time to, you know, be in Pittsburgh in general, because I feel like Pittsburgh is kind of experiencing a really interesting and really amazing food renaissance right now. There are just so many great restaurants opening up, so many awesome chefs doing crazy things exciting things with food right now, but it's even exciting to be vegan or plant-based in the city because there are so many options. So there are some really great standalone vegan restaurants right now. I know Zenith in Southside, we used to live like a block away from there. They have great brunches on the weekends. Onion Maiden, I know we did a story, I think it was my first story with you guys. They have a fish fry this time of year. It's vegan. It's crazy. It's so good.
Onion Maiden is delicious. Even yes. if you don't think you like plant-based food, it's everything there is amazing. And they have donuts.
Totally. Yes, of course. And you can't like get away with a donut. Kyber in Polish Hill actually carries a lot of vegan dishes too, but they also have some vegan donuts, I think, on the weekends still. I think from Wolf Teeth Donuts that are like the best donuts I've ever had. But, you know, there are some Pittsburgh staples that are now introducing vegan recipes into their menus, which I think is so cool. We did a post about Gaucho, which is like a meat haven for so many people.
So I really love the Gaucho story because I think one of the misnomers is that there's either vegan restaurants or non-vegan restaurants. And one of the things that you've done so well for us is explain how you can go to that restaurant, how someone who is plant-based and someone who eats meat can both enjoy the experience at a restaurant like Gaucho.
For sure. Yeah. And I mean, they do have so many great vegan options. Their salads, you can't go wrong with grilled bread, in my opinion. Their sauces are insane. It's just a great place. But one of my favorites, so my boyfriend is not vegan. He's not plant-based, but our favorite date day is just hitting up South Highland in Shadyside. So we do like Atta for coffee. They have really great oat milk. It's my favorite oat milk ever. It's like a European country or a European brand. And it was like the first thing I scoped out when I was in London last year. I love it so much. And then we do Urban Tap for happy hour and then Noodlehead for dinner, which we can both get. I can easily eat vegan there. We did a post about that too. And then Millie's for dessert. So like, it's just a great way for both of us to get the food that makes us feel good, the food that makes us happy.
So a lot of these restaurants, given the fact that we are in quarantine times, are mm-hmm. shut down, but I know a lot of them are offering delivery. Do you have any plant-based delivery recommendations?
Yeah, man, it's just such an interesting season that we're in right now. So gift cards are always a great option, I think, because a lot of people have gift card orders right on their website now, or you could just order them via email. So that's a good way to support businesses right now, even if you're not ready to, you know, eat out or order delivery. But I'm a huge coffee fan, and there are some really cool companies doing some really great things here in Pittsburgh. I mentioned Atta before, and they're doing an Instagram giveaways pretty much every day, I think, that if you show them that you're supporting local businesses by ordering takeout, or if you tag someone who's like on the front line supporting people with the virus, you can like enter a giveaway. So they're just incredible. They're doing awesome things right now. La Prima is another one, which is like my favorite coffee in the city, obviously. But you can order their coffee off their website, but they also have a special Venmo set up to help support their baristas, which I think is really great. And kind of related to COVID, it's like not really, but it's still a local business that you can support. Grounds and Hounds is really great. I feel like they're kind of unknown right now because they don't have a brick and mortar here in Pittsburgh, but they are a Pittsburgh-based company and their slogan is every pound saves a hound. So like obviously near and dear to my heart, coffee and floofs, like how much better could that be?
And when you say floofs, are you talking dogs or dogs and cats?
Any kind of animal. But okay. Yeah, so they donate 20% of their profits to animal rescue organizations, which I think is great. And they have great coffees, including like single origins, but they also have really cute merchandise too. Like they have a shirt that says love like a dog. And I just think that's the cutest thing ever.
And Grounds and Hounds is available on their website.
Yep. Another great way that you can support local businesses right now is to support your friends and family. So if you are ordering takeout or you are placing an order at some of these companies, ask around for your friends and family and say, hey, I'm putting in an order. What can I get you? Our friends, Gretchen and Dan, just did this for us. They picked up some beer for us from 11th Hour. And like, there was nothing better than when the beer fairy comes around. So it's just a great way to put a little bit of extra into your order and also support your friends and family.
That's a great idea. And to save someone a trip out of their house.
Exactly. Yeah. And you can just drop it off right at their door and say, you know, send them a text and say, hey, it's out there. Enjoy. Like very contact free, but it's still a great way to just kind of spread the love a little bit right now.
What are some other local food bloggers or local blogs that you follow on a regular basis?
Yeah, that's a really great question. So I actually used to work for Jessica from How Sweet Eats. I used to do some social stuff for her. She's just an incredible powerhouse of a blogger and business owner and just a boss. She's amazing. She has had her blog for at least 10 years now, and she publishes every day, multiple times a day. I don't know how she does it, especially with two young kids. She's just like what food bloggers aspire to be. She's incredible. And then Erin from The Almond Eater, I'm friends with her. She's great, very passionate, and just so talented with especially photography. She does a lot of plant-based stuff as well, but she's incredible. And then Isabel Eats, she used to be in Pittsburgh. She recently relocated to Oklahoma, but I think she's a Pittsburgher at heart still. So definitely send her some love as well.
You mentioned something very important a few minutes ago that I need to go back to. Mm-hmm. We have to talk about bread.
Obviously.
And
yes.
Now everyone is baking their own bread. Mm-hmm. What are you baking? Where does a bread novice like myself get started?
Mm-hmm. Great questions. So I have a bread ebook. My blogging friend actually put it out. Her blog is called Life as a Strawberry, which is just the best name ever. She has this artisan bread ebook that I've been baking my way through, and it has been a delicious experience for sure. But if you're just starting out with bread, I absolutely recommend just looking for a no-knead bread option. I know Pinch of Yum has a really great recipe for that. You can find that on pinchofyum.com. And it couldn't be simpler. You just like mix the flour, yeast, salt, and water together the night before. You let it sit for 12 hours and then you bake it the next day. Like, it's so simple, and you have homemade bread and a built-in air freshener, because your house will never smell better after you bring bread out of the oven. So it's just been such a fun experiment, you know, to experiment with different flours. Then once you kind of master one recipe, you can start subbing in like a little bit of whole wheat flour for the all-purpose or bread flour. So there's just a lot that you can do with those simple four ingredients.
Now, according to my Facebook feed, flour has been hard to obtain right now.
Oh yeah.
Where do you shop for supplies normally and in a time of quarantine? Are there stores or places you'd recommend for locating that secret stash of flour, or just like a better place to pick up yeast or ingredients? Do you have any favorites?
Yeah. So we did go grocery shopping. It was probably last week. We try not to go grocery shopping unless we absolutely need to right now. So we went to Whole Foods and Aldi. Whole Foods was kind of picked over. Aldi had a ton of yeast left. They did have some flour. So that would be a good recommendation. You can also look online. I'm very loyal. I work with them, full disclosure, but I'm very loyal to Bob's Red Mill. But their website has been picked over quite a bit too. It's great to see that people's love of baking has kind of emerged out of this very terrible situation. But yeah, I would just say be consistent and look online. There are a lot of creative places that you can go to find those ingredients if you need them. And Dianoia's, is that how you pronounce it?
I think so.
Yeah. So the bread baker there, he has his own like bread company. I think it's called Wild Science Bread. Definitely go check him out on Instagram too, because he is like bread goals right now. He does like a lot of awesome flavor riffs and stuff like that. So it's just a great place to find some inspiration too.
Any other favorite Pittsburgh places you'd want to share, or places you wish more people knew about?
Yeah, I'm looking at my list. I'm sorry.
That's okay. Grounds and Hounds is a great suggestion.
Yeah, they're awesome. Yeah. So some things, if you have Omni kind of eaters in your household, Kaya is a great place to go. They are they've been around forever, and they're just like a Pittsburgh staple at this point, but they have a monthly vegan vegetarian night. That would be a great option if you wanted to do some experimenting with your diet. And also Altius, which is like super high-end restaurant on Mount Washington, they have vegan options now. And they are definitely one of those places that you can just get an awesome experience, beautiful views of the city, and really great vegan food. So those were the two I definitely wanted to mention as well, because we've had great experiences there recently.
awesome. I did not know Altius had some vegan options. What's missing in the Pittsburgh plant-based eating scene? Or what are some things I know you've been to London. What are some things you wish we had that haven't quite made it to Pittsburgh yet?
I would love to see a vegan-only bakery somewhere, like a standalone, like in the Strip. It would be awesome to see something that could stand alongside like Peace Love and Little Donuts or some of the other awesome like staples in Pittsburgh. I'm a huge like baked goods fan. So
Oakmont
I would love
Bakery
to see.
Does not do vegan.
Yeah, no, which is such a bummer.
But they kind of laughed at me when I asked about vegan baked goods.
Totally. Yeah. And I mean, that's okay, to each their own. Like I am a firm believer that one diet does not fit all for everybody. Like vegan works best for me. But I think that would be really cool to see a standalone vegan restaurant. And I know some people are doing it, you know, from their homes or it's like part of a different like menu somewhere. So I think we're getting there. I just haven't seen it yet. So I'm hoping if you're out there listening, please, I need it.
One of the questions we ask everyone on the show is, what is your favorite bridge? Do you have a favorite bridge in or around Pittsburgh?
Yes. Well, that's like the best Pittsburgh question ever. And it was like
we
the easiest. So. Yeah, it's like the easiest answer for me. The Clemente Bridge, for sure. I just have such strong memories of going to Pirate games with my family. We would park in the city and walk across it, you know, before and after the game. And it's just full of Yinzers. And it's just a great atmosphere. It has a beautiful view of PNC Park. And it's just definitely one of my favorite places in the city, for sure, just because of all those memories, but definitely my favorite bridge.
I'm glad you were able to chat with me this morning and excited to share. These are some great suggestions and thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks so much. This was so fun. We appreciate it.
For more recipes and beautiful food photos of what Alexa is cooking, check out Alexa's website, Fooduzzi.com, Fooduzzi.com. You can also follow Alexa on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Her handles are Fooduzzi, Fooduzzi. Everything looks delicious.
We've reached the spot in this podcast that is perfect for an ad. Why not make your small business a part of the slaw? And then this little bit of time could be where I shout out all the great things you do or sell or make. Email us for more info at hellopittsburgh@verylocal.com. That's HelloPittsburgh at verylocal.com. Hi everyone, it's Stephanie, and I just wanted to shout out the new Pittsburgh Open for Business map that was put together by Allegheny Together. And you might have, like me, been wondering who or what is Allegheny Together, so I looked that up for you. Allegheny Together is a program of Allegheny County Economic Development in conjunction with County Executive Rich Fitzgerald's office, and essentially they're there for strategic planning and technical support for traditional business districts. They're doing a lot to help downtown shopping districts thrive. And so, of course, since we've undergone vast changes due to quarantine and COVID-19, Allegheny Together was inspired by the ubiquitous Code for Pittsburgh fish fry map that a lot of you turn to at the beginning of fish fry season. And they've made something very similar called PGH Open for Business. If you are a business owner, you essentially fill out a short survey on their website, AlleghenyTogether.com, and they will then upload all of that information to the Google Map a couple times a week. You can filter by categories, so there's takeout and there's grocery stores and there's pharmacies. And essentially, if you are a consumer, I think what the map really highlights is the opportunity to support some of the smaller folks that you might not think of during this time. So folks that might not be listed in other sources, either in your own neighborhood or if you happen to be going to another neighborhood to, you know, drop off something or to pick up, you know, something that you've ordered for curbside pickup, it might be nice to get takeout from a smaller business that you wouldn't know in a different neighborhood and support some of those folks as well, because we're all in this together. So shout out to Allegheny Together's PGH Open for Business map.
Before we let you go, we are going to share one quick collaboration. It's got a pretty cool beneficial twist to it. It's actually a worldwide beer collaboration started in New York, and it has found its way to Pittsburgh. So the collab is called All Together. All Together is a collaboration beer being brewed and sold to benefit hospitality professionals who are currently out of work. It started at Other Half Brewing in New York, and it has slowly kind of trickled out, and it's found its way to 636 breweries in 41 countries. All of them are brewing their own take on All Together. Now, to make All Together, you just go to their website. It's just alltogether.beer. And there, you'll find the beer recipe, which is totally free, open source. And the can label, the design, the branding, all of that stuff's ready to go. And the best part, the beer is meant to be brewed and manufactured at a low cost using readily available ingredients for most brewers. That way, when the beer is packaged up and sold, a portion of the proceeds can go back to benefit hospitality professionals who are hurting right now. Now, out of all those breweries, locally here in Pittsburgh, Hitchhiker already has All Together available right now, with a portion of their proceeds going back to benefit a fund that helps their bartending staff. Dancing Gnome plans to release All Together on April 29th, with proceeds from their sales going to benefit the Brewers Guild. East End plans to release All Together on May 12th, and again, a portion of their sales will go back to benefit a fund. Other local breweries involved with All Together are Voodoo, Gristhouse, Cinderlands, 11th Hour, Roundabout, Hop Farm. I'm sure I'm missing others as well, but I just thought this was a really cool collab. I think it's awesome to see something where our local breweries and bartenders and friends can create something that goes back to benefit the service industry. I know I can't wait for all of us to be able to have a beer together again soon. So I just want to say cheers. Thanks for listening, as always. Check out All Together. All Together, a worldwide collaboration benefit beer, has found its way to Pittsburgh, and every sale of All Together goes back to benefit our local hospitality professionals who need our help right now. Thanks so much.
Make sure you subscribe,
rate, and review The Slaw on iTunes
or wherever you listen to podcasts.